Hey guys, welcome back to the channel for another video. I'm Batman, and today we're going to talk about all the actors trying to be me. Well, actually, we're going to talk about why Robert Pattinson, the new Batman, or Battinson, we'll call him. We're going to talk about why he doesn't want to become the Batman. More specifically, why he doesn't want to method act to get into this role through production. I mean, who wouldn't want to be Batman, right? Everyone wants to be Batman. But Pattinson does raise some good points on why you might not want to be Batman after all. Or at least not for weeks or months at a time. Because the job of being Batman is hard. Sure, it's cool protecting Gotham and beating up thugs throughout the night and getting to rock a sick utility belt that can hold your shark repellent next to your napalm.
Hand me down the shark repellent bat spray!
But being Batman also comes with a lot of hard work and a lot of sleepless nights. So that's why we're here today. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any upcoming videos. We've got a great community here that loves to talk about all the same things that you love to talk about. So be sure to go down and hit that red button to join the community. And if you want to be like Batman one day, while you're down there, let's see you can punch the like button faster. You or Batman. 3, 2, 1, go. Ooh. Batman? Yo, dude, chill. More? Really? Way to go! Batman broke the like button, everybody. No, but on a real note, this was the moment where I knew they had something with this new Batman movie. This is how young Batman should be with thugs. Just absolutely brutal. That's what we want to see. This Batman has found its way to be different from all the others, and that's why this movie is going to do so well. Part of what made the Nolan Batman great was Heath Ledger's amazing method acting for playing the Joker. Ledger would lock himself away in isolation in a hotel room for a month at a time, scribbling down different voices in his diary as the Joker. He quite literally became the Joker. During production, he was the same person off-screen as he was on-screen, which is scary to think about. Method acting is this technique or type of acting where the actor aspires to get emotionally accurate performances by fully inhabiting the role of the character they're playing. It's a very emotional-based technique rather than the more popular action-focused form of acting. Some of the greatest performances ever have come from method acting, so just like you, when I heard Pattinson wasn't going to do it for such an iconic role, I had to know why. Robert Pattinson has this ability when he's acting to make it seem like there's a soul to this character he's playing, while at the same time, behind the walls of whatever facade his character is displaying, you can tell there's some kind of darkness, something mysterious lying beneath the skin. He first did this with Edward in Twilight. He's supposed to be this monster who's capable of loving and being humane, while at the same time, he could snap at any second into a huge violent outburst. He was dangerous. Even as Cedric Diggory in Harry Potter, his character was this brave, heroic guy who was super nice, but there was just something you didn't trust about this guy. Something, I don't know, was a bit off. And this is what's going to help him be such a great Batman. He's going to be playing a version of Bruce Wayne where, to the outside, Gotham's going to see him as this shut-in billionaire, only getting out for political events and charities, and while he's smiling, people will always think there's more to him than meets the eye. Which is exactly what Batman is as a character. It's like the YouTube channel. On average, only 8% of my current viewers are subscribed, which is crazy. Shout out to the 8%. And if you're part of the other 90%, what are you even doing? Go down and punch that subscribe button. It'll make you Batman. But there's more to this YouTube channel than meets the eye. We also have this top secret Discord server where only the best of the 8% can come and hang out. And yes, that includes you. We just had a movie night last week, and this week we have a spooky Among Us game night. If you want to join, you can go down to the link in the pinned comment, and it will take you directly to the spookiest Discord on the planet. Just make sure you don't tell anyone. But that's exactly what I'm saying. Bruce Wayne and Batman are two different people.
How can this guy put on a cape and a cowl and no one knows him? That's just impossible. Why don't you let me do two voices? And let me use my own voice for Bruce Wayne, and then I'll use the voice that I used in the audition for Batman. Why don't we try that?
I actually did check this against any musical sounds. Computer still can't come close to pinpointing it.
Wayne Manor, one moment, please. A call for Master Bruce from a Dr. March.
Hey, what's up, Doc?
This is part of what makes Bruce Wayne different from Batman. This is why people don't know that this masked vigilante running around their city at night is actually the billionaire living down the street in the big house on the hill. And Robert Pattinson has this feel, this vibe, this ability to seemingly hide something dark within his character more than anybody else. The look in his eyes, the way he carries himself, you can tell that he's hiding something. You don't know if he's actually a dark vigilante running around the city, beating up all the thugs, or if he's just into some weird anime. You never know. In a recent interview, Pattinson said that he just can't imagine taking all that home with you at the end of the day. It's exhausting. After the director says cut, you need to be able to let all that go. He also pointed out that the majority of the time that you see someone method acting is when they're playing an a-hole, which I feel like it's pretty accurate the majority of the time. Look at Jared Leto, for instance. When he played Joker in Suicide Squad, he took it a little too seriously. He ended up giving Margot Robbie a live rat at one point. He ended up having a literal henchman deliver a dead pig to his co-stars. I mean, he just did some really messed up stuff. Pushed the boundaries a little too far. There's a line in the sand called professionalism, where you respect everyone else's boundaries and methods as actors, and not only did Jared Leto take a 10-foot leap over that line, he sat down and built a 5-foot-tall sandcastle out of leftover food sitting in the bottom of his refrigerator. I mean, who walks in and plops down a dead pig on the table and then just walks out? If you worked anywhere else, you would get fired and banned from all establishments for life. Can you imagine if someone from McDonald's did this? Fired, banned, probably taken to court. Why can this guy do it and this guy can't? Because he's method acting. He's not actually crazy. I mean, this literally loops right back around and reinforces what Pattinson said earlier about the majority of the people who are doing this are acting like a-holes. Not all of them, but there's a lot. Rest assured, the Pattinson will be in a completely separate universe from Leto's Joker. He's never going to have to deal with any of that, thank goodness. I remember when the movie came out and all the interviews with the rest of the cast were just talking about all the ways Leto tortured them throughout production, and I just felt so bad for everyone that they had to deal with him on set for 6 months. It didn't make me respect the guy, it just made him seem like an a-hole. And I get that he was going for a super polarizing Joker, something so different from the last one because Ledger did such a good job you just couldn't try to copy it or you'd be criticized and you would fall short. He just had to do something so different and so drastic, but he didn't go the right direction in my opinion. I mean, I'm sure the director and writers and everyone else had a part to play in this too, but look at the Joker movie. That's a good example of an interpretation of the Joker that came after the legendary performance, but was still good. It was different and unique in its own way, and it took a spin on the character like we've never seen before. I mean, so did Leto's. It's just a good example versus a bad example. Pattinson said that he's just going to try to make a movie that he himself would want to go watch, and chances are there'll be at least one other person, that's me, that would want to go out and watch it too. He's also said that he's just going to try to give the audience something they didn't know they wanted, and I think he hit the nail on the head with this new Batman movie, just based off the little tiny bit we've seen from the trailer. I had no idea that I needed to see a sleep-deprived, makeup-covered Bruce Wayne, and I had no idea I needed to see Batman beat a guy senseless after he's already been knocked to the ground. This trailer, the tone it has, it caught everyone off guard. No one could have predicted that this is what they meant when they said they were making another Batman movie. I thought they meant something like this.
A bat bomb? Search up!
So for this new movie, Robert Pattinson is not going to be method acting. While he says that obviously he very much respects the actors that do choose to do it, it's just not for him. He says that he needs to have that disconnect between his part in a film and his real life, which makes total sense. I can't imagine becoming another person for days, weeks, months at a time. I have so much respect for people that do that because that in itself seems like such a crazy feat. He says he needs to know when he's on stage and when he's off stage. He needs to know that between action and cut, that's it. That's the thing. That's the safe space. He needs to know that it ends. When you know there's a cut coming and you can just drop it, you feel safe. It's just when you feel like you can't get out, that's when people start to go crazy. And this Batman movie is going to be much darker than the Nolan films. Bruce Wayne is going to be putting himself through a lot, both mentally and physically. My guess is that he's going to be pulling a lot of all-nighters and will probably be on the brink of going a little mad himself. Method acting for this Batman would be extremely tough. It's not an easy feat, so I completely understand him not wanting to do it. Even without it, I still think just from the trailer alone, he's going to do a great job as the Bat. I heard his movie The Lighthouse, which just came out, is really good. I just put that on my watch list too, which if you're interested in seeing the 294 movies that I need to watch, you can check it out in the Discord as well. But in The Lighthouse, Pattinson did a little bit of method acting. Because he was playing this person who was mad from isolation, he could kind of just act mad on set for an hour or two. He would go wander around and get into it. He ate some mud, pissed his pants, you know, did things that someone who was mad would do. For some of those scenes that he was supposed to be drunk off of kerosene, he would literally just be unconscious. He spent so much time doing revolting things like making himself throw up and just sitting in puddles of mud growling that he's not ready to go do something like method act for this Batman movie. And going into this, before we saw the trailer, I was extremely skeptical, just like everyone else, of Robert Pattinson playing Batman. I was not a Pattinson aficionado. I had never seen any of his movies until recently, where I saw a bit of him in the Twilight movies, where he was this teenage girl heartthrob of a vampire, and then Water for Elephants, which he was good in, but off of those, I couldn't see him as Batman. But after that trailer dropped, seeing how dark the tone is and how well that works with Pattinson as an actor and the tone he carries for the role, now I can confidently say that I completely trust him with Batman. Thank you guys so much for watching my 100th video on the channel. Yes, that is right, the big 100. Go smash the like button 100 times or something. No, but honestly, I was hoping to do something a little more special for this, like release merch or announce Patreon or do a Fiverr video or announce Twitch, but unfortunately, I just didn't have the time. I'm still working on all those things, but I've realized it's much harder to find someone that sells t-shirts and hoodies in this specific color and more pastel type colors like it than I expected, so unfortunately, things are taking a little bit longer. But in the meantime, if you want to come hang out, do some gaming, watch some scary movies in October with me, you can head over to the Discord for a fun time. There's a lot of cool people there. We always have a good time and you'll make some new friends. I will see you next week with another video, but until then, I will see you in the comments. Peace.
What's the code?